look when, if you're 12, you look back and think when you were 9. But of course I do think about it, and I'm very interested and fascinated how many artists I speak to and others that I read about or know, older artists, are using their early ideas and work in all kinds of often really remarkable ways. And that is one of the great possibilities of being old.
Yeah? I want to hear about your early years, because you were in New York in the 50s and 60s, at a time when it was a burgeoning time for the New York art world, and you rubbed shoulders with a lot of pretty amazing people. And in fact, you just told me a story about how you got a grant through de Kooning somehow.
Yeah.
You want to talk a little about that and other things?
Well, I was living on 3rd Avenue between 9th and 10th Street. 10th Street was, I believe, the downtown art world. When you think of that, everything about it is extraordinary because it was tiny. That's a block, right? A block here is full of galleries, but it's just one block. That was a short block, too, 10th Street between 3rd and 4th or Broadway, whatever. And everybody was like this, and they were on the stoops of the galleries. So they were sitting and talking or standing and fighting, a lot of argument about abstract versus figurative, and, you know, endless, to me, that aspect, very boring. But there was wonderful, you know, crossings going over, and the block had a space in the middle of nothing, just nothing, you know, a little bit this and that growing. And the back of my studio faced a building that de Kooning was in and a whole bunch of other artists. And so I knew him, we weren't close friends, but I knew him. I did not love his painting initially. I came to love it a lot. But to describe the street life, I was walking across the street, he was on the other side, and he yelled at me something like, "Mary, did you ever get us something grand?" And I didn't know what he was talking about. I said, "No, you know." And I did get that grant then. But I mean, you know, no papers, no legal, no secretaries, no internet, no type, I mean, nothing. Well, I was very lucky, of course, but it's just to convey, you know, there was a great bareback rider with a circus on my block, Alfred Leslie, Resnick, you know, Vicente, oh, just all these people. Some I knew better than others, but it was the cross, you know, the crossings over. And it was. I couldn't realize how extraordinary it was until later, because when you're in something, it's normal. Does that help?